from you, man.
You got no anger.
You know?
You got that left for us.
Dalton Johnson, nigga.
Yeah, what happened to him? Okay, he just pleased the bullet. He didn't stop. Or that dude, he's just...
They
paying him good money.
Like we're some type of spectacle or something to look at or some type of entertainment for them to be a part of. Not realizing the true value in all the things that we're really talking about. Okay, the value of what we're talking about is that you have the opportunity to save your soul, to save your spirit, you know? But if you don't take heed to the words that we're reading, you're too busy looking, oh, I know that dude. I went to high school, but that dude was this good at that, but he was never really this. That's not the point of this. The point of this that men are delivering it to you so you can ask a man question and get a man answer. Alright? Not for no angel to come down and break it down to you, the Lord himself to come down and break it down to you. But for a man to break it down so you can get it. Okay, in plain speech. It says, for we are fools for Hamashiach's sake. But we are wiser than Hamashiach. Talking about Yahweh Shai. He said, we are weak. For ye are strong, ye are honorable, but ye are strong. We look at it as something low and terrible, but we're really honorable in the eyes of the Heavenly Father. Because we don't care what you people think of us. Not today, we don't care what we appear. We don't care what we appear. We don't care what we appear. We don't care what we appear.
To show you how powerful the Most High is. The foolishness of the Most High. Wiser than the wisdom of men, because the foolishness of preaching, the foolishness that the world sees that we were doing, this is what's causing the change. Okay, you don't even see it, but we're putting up a vibration up there, and it's causing major changes that people all over the world are hearkening to this thing. Okay? Whether you against it or for it, this is causing. Even the higher ups to pay attention to this, man. A lot of our people are waking out of graves, man. You can't tell me that even though this may be considered foolish, you can't tell me this ain't being very impactful, man. You can't say this isn't making a heavy impact on the world, man. Because it definitely is. All right, they trying to make movies and all type of stuff, man. They sending all type of pastors against us. We're ending up on mainstream news. You know, this thing is everywhere. And this is what's making the change, man, because the words that we're speaking is not our words, these are the words of the Most High.
That's right.
And everything that he said that he would do, he said that he's gonna do it.
We're doing it.
Okay.
Well, what he said was, you have my YouTube, they changed the guidelines time and time again because of us. It ain't because of talking. Vibration of this man's downfall out there before his face, and it's starting to wake up. And with no problem, when nobody was waking up. Now that people have been waking up all over the world, it's a problem.
Yeah, you. A lot of Jake in the Christian church is coming up out of that bullshit because of us. Because they want answers, man. There's a lot of unanswered questions as long as they've been in the Christian church, and they've been trying to ask their pastors, you know, what's up, and they ain't getting no thorough answers. So they turning to us for those answers. Man.
1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 1, I'm reading through 5. And I, brethren, when I came to you, came not with excellency of speech or of wisdom, declaring unto you the testimony of Yahweh by Shem Yahushai.
And not with excellent speech or eloquent words, proper English. But what it said in Isaiah, but with stammering lips and another tongue, he speak to his people.
Though I be rude in speech, yet not in knowledge.
But my But I've been manifesting all things and everything that we're talking about. We're showing you the proof and the manifestation of the words of the Heavenly Father.
For I determined not to know anything among you, save Yahweh Shai Mashiach and him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power.
And in truth, what really attracts everybody to this word is the truth. The truth is like, when you hear a great comedian speak, you're mostly entertained by the truth that he speaks.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, he'll make you laugh, he'll do a few silly things, get you laughing, but once he's got your mind open, your ear open, now he's supposed to plug in truth to you. And that's what makes comedians such great entertainers with that, okay? But it's that truth, and we speak the truth of the Heavenly Father, prophetic truth, that you can't deny. You can't tell me that RFID chip ain't the mark of the beast, and what is the mark of the beast? And why, and this ain't the time? Everything is ready. You're telling me that those arrows are missiles? Then what else is it? Okay, there's truth in everything that we're talking about. Dietary laws, there's truth. Everything.
Yeah, the so-called UFOs are in the Bible. Yep. We give you the scriptures on it, man.
Right.
We give you the answers according to the Bible, man. This Bible is the foundation of life, man. You know?
Right. I had a quick precept my brother gave me. 1 Edges chapter 4 and 38. As for the truth, it endureth and is always strong. You can't knock the truth down. No matter who they send up against us, you can't knock it down. You can't get us to fold. You can send all the wisdom of the world can't match up against the truth of the Most High. And that's the words that the real prophet speak, the truth of the Most High. He said, it liveth and conquereth forever. Loves truth is gonna love this word. We know you either don't like it, okay? Because you want to keep the deception going. You want to stay in power. But the real truth is, we're up next. We got one that's got to rule the world of righteousness and instruct the world and the guiders of righteousness in the world.
The Book of Acts, chapter 5. Verse 38, and now I say unto you, refrain from these men, and let them alone. For if this counsel or this work be of man, it will come to naught. But if it be of the Most High, ye cannot overthrow it, lest haply ye be found even to fight against the Most High.
Darn, that's with this wisdom, man. Hey, this isn't coming to naught because the Most High is orchestrating it, man. Hey, the words that we speak, and they're not our words. You know, it's all through the Spirit that we're able to come out here and bring the message into the Hakim, through the unicorn, man. That's all the Most High is doing. You know, he set us in this position to do this work, man. No brother can tell you that 20 years ago, 5 years ago, before they were in the truth, they can't say, yeah, I knew I was going to do this. You know, because that's when the scripture comes in. Also, where it says, goings are of the Lord.
Yep.
You know, how then can a man understand his own way? Hey, because the Most High is orchestrating this. Hey, through wisdom, right now, and the next is going to be set up, man. You know, that's just how the Most High is leading to me.
This is verse 39. But if it be of the Most High, ye cannot overthrow it. Lest haply ye be found even to fight against Yahweh Shai Mashiach.
That's why it says in Luke, you know, he that despiseth me, and he that despiseth me, despiseth him that sent me, man. So if you condemn us for what we out here speaking, then really. really, you're coming against the Most High himself. So, hey, you think you want that fight?
You want that smoke?
Your arms too short to box the Most High.
Yeah, man. Because the truth is going to prevail either way, man.
Acts 17:6. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the rulers of the city, crying, these that have turned the world upside down are come hither also.
turn everything upside down, and y'all cause it ugly, man. You know, this doctrine that you have, this Yahweh Shai doctrine.
Side up because we saw has turned it upside down, pursuant to Isaiah 29:16.
Exactly. Our people, you know, they're in a slumber, they're in the Gentiles state of mind. All they know how to do is just live the way the Gentiles live. That's the only way they know, especially if there's nothing new under the sun, man. You know? Jake is in their Gentile ways. That's a lot, bro. I don't know if it was more on that.
Pretty much the point, because you know, the apostles back in Acts, man, they basically, you know, pissing people off, man.
Yeah.
You know, and they got attacked, you know, they got, you know, beat up and stuff like that. But they still, you know, had the spirit to, you know, after being attacked and whatnot, they had still had the spirit to preach on, man. But those mine enemies, which would not that I should reign over them,
yep,
bring hither and slay them before me.
Slay them, kill them before the Lord. You know, if you're not gonna get on board and get right, you gotta go. You gotta get wiped out, man. I'm talking specifically to you, Chase. If you're not in the 230s, if you're not gonna get right, you're gonna straight up kill them. Anybody else, you're gonna either get killed or be put into a servitude position as a heathen are supposed to be in under the Israelites. Right? Thus saith the Bible. That he hath done, whether it be good or bad. Knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men.
God, knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. Hey, which is why we out on the highways and hedges, you know, telling you, you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and you need to come back and hearken unto the words of the Heavenly Father, or else you're going to get killed. Plain and simple, man. Hey, the most high is plain, short and sweet. You know, it's either black or white, it's no gray area.
Iniquity,
but his blood will I require at thy hand.
God, so that's what like a trumpet and show my people all their transgressions and the house of Jacob's their sins. So that's what we're doing. We're telling you that you're going off and the life that you're living is contrary unto the scriptures. And if you don't change that, the Lord is going to kill you.
Right.
And so by us doing that, the Lord is allowing us to have our hands washed of your blood, and now you're going to have to pay for the sins that you do in your body, man.
Right.
That's Ezekiel 3?
Yeah. God. It says 33.
33. So
verse 9, nevertheless, if thou warn the wicked of his way to turn from it,
which is what we're doing,
if he do not turn from his way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul.
Kind. So by us warning you, hey, we Lord willing, we deliver from it, and you gonna still have to die for your sin, man.
It'd be cool if you woke up and you were delivered also.
Hey, kind.
But if you don't, he ain't worried about it.
And it's beautiful how the Lord, y'all, Bashem El-Shai, how they make separations, man. And because one, you have on one side, you have the men of the Lord on every highway and edges, telling you, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans to come back into the words and start walking in the paths of the scriptures. Hey, but on the opposite side of that, you have your pulpit preachers not telling you what the evils that you're doing, and you're going to die in your sin, man. That's the difference. And you think it's all joy going into the church house. You know, you think it's all good delivering or giving your money into that the collection plate. Talking about all you tribes, you northern kingdoms included, man. Talking about you Hispanics. Hey, so you gonna get it too. Because the pastor isn't warning you. He's just telling you, oh yeah, just repent. You know, keep giving your money into the church. You know, that's what they're telling you to do. But they're not telling you what repenting is, man. You know, they're not telling you that it means to turn away from the things that you're doing.
Says in the scriptures how the priests, they don't separate that really from the profane. You're supposed to bring it to your mind so that you can repent, because if you notice, every time we went into captivity, you know, the Lord would send the prophets out to warn them why they're going through what they're going through. And the moment that they realize that, they start to feel sorrow, they start to repent, and they acknowledge their offenses. You know, like it says, out the street. You know?
Yeah. Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 2 through 4. The burden of Habakkuk the prophet did see. O Lord, how long shall I cry and thou would not hear? Even
from. That's what we're trying to do with this.
for the law is slack, and judgment does never go forth. For the wicked doth pass about the righteous. Therefore, wrong judgment proceedeth.
Continue to, you know, secretly worship their idols, you know, sacrificing animals to demons. And it was basically, it was no judgment. They were just letting Jake be wicked as all hell. And that's why at one point in time, you know, both kingdoms, Judah and Israel, were both going off. They was all being wicked, man. And that's why there was no consequences. So that's when the Lord started sending these other nations out.
Grandmamas cooking pork in the church.
The pastor
is having sex with a bunch of people in the church. You know? And they had those
little boys, certainly gonna get them too.
Kind.
I'm talking black church too.
Yeah,
that movie Red Hook Summer, I think it was called. And we're talking about that also. How even the black church.
You got a bunch of sodomites, dykes, homosexuals in the church. You know, that's messy in the church, man. A lot of messy ass shit, trifling shit. That shit will push people away. Don't even want to be involved with that. Judgment, thou shalt not respect persons, neither take a gift, for a gift doth blind the eyes of the wise and pervert the words of the righteous.
W-R-E-S-T.
Yeah, rest.
Basically wrestle against the judgment. You can't change the judgment. Stop wrestling against it. This is the judgment of the creator. It's the potter himself.
He said, no respect for persons. So if somebody is on a certain status within the society, don't try to not. Judgment or condemnation because they looked up as something else, you know, as something special. Hey, the same thing applies to them. Hey, for example, that nigga Snoop. Snoop is gonna still die the death of a two-third, man. Regardless of what he did in this society.
Die the death of a bitch.
Stand a chance in the court system, in the judicial system. But if you have some type of status or you have money, you could bribe the judge and get less judgments.
Like if you were to turn it into sorority,
so you know the secret handshakes, handshakes.
That's not how it's supposed to be, man. You're supposed to judge righteous judgment. You know? But that's what those wicked priests were doing. You know? And there was no judgment going out, so therefore, a lot of wickedness was going on, man. You allow a lot of wickedness to go on, you're just going to be surrounded in that shit, man. And then it says in Corinthians, evil communication corrupts good manners. Right. So even if you stand on certain principles, if you're surrounded by it so much, that shit can actually taint you. Right. It cause you to go off if there's so much of it around you. So that's why you gotta cut that shit off, man. A little leaven, leaven the whole lump.
If your eye be evil, pluck it out. Yeah. Get that off.
And the script said something you get with gifts, right?
Yeah, meaning you get bribed.
Huh, because the scriptures tell you the gift destroys the heart. You know?
Get bribed. Right. From sound balance of judgment.
Hey, because that's also we can look at that with the politicians. You know? Because whether it be the high politicians or the low level. Hey, they'll get certain gifts or money at their front door.
Lobbyists.
They'll put it right at their doorstep. Take it. Next thing you know, their mind state of what they're supposed to vote on or stand on, it changes, man.
Jeremiah 23, at the top, verse 1, it says, woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahushua. Hey, woe unto you, because you're not teaching the righteousness of the Heavenly Father, but you're pushing out ways of society and the ways of the Catholic and Christian Church, and stirring the people away from the true judgment of the Heavenly Father, about His image, about His works, about His personality and what He can do, about who he loves and who He has chosen. Okay? It says, therefore, thus said the Lord Yahweh, power of Israel, against the pastors that feed my people. Ye have scattered my flock and driven them away, and have not visited them. Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doings, saith the Lord Yahweh. It says, and I will gather the remnant of my flock out of all countries whither I have driven them, and will bring them again to their folds, and they shall be fruitful and increase. We're talking about his elect that's going to rebuild the nation of the souls of the two-thirds after the two-thirds get death by pain. Okay, you got to come back in a righteous state of mind, but that judgment has to happen until, because you allow a weak-ass pastor and a weak-ass doctor to sift you out, to pull you away from heaven's cross, to scatter you into everywhere that doctor. Jeremiah 14, starting at verse 10, it said, thus saith the Lord Yahweh unto this people, thus have they loved to wander and have not refrained their feet. Therefore the Lord Yahweh doeth not accept them. He will now remember their iniquity and visit their sins. The scripture in the second episode, both of them,
that righteous man on mine? No.
Let me back that real quick. Can't hold it right. Second Ezra 16, it's like the last verse. The one time that we bound.
Second Ezra 16 to 17.
Second Ezra chapter 16, verse 77, it says, woe be unto them that are bound with their iniquities and covered with to their sins and covered with their iniquities. And that's what it's talking about. Both means death or destruction. That's what you're going to get. Because you have not done the things that get you away from it. Okay? That they have not been blotted out. He's not going to forgive those of the two-thirds. Iniquity and sins of the two-thirds. Back in Jeremiah 14, it says, said the Lord Yahweh unto me, pray not for this people for their good.
God. He said, pray not for this people for their good. Because when you look at Jeremiah once pleaded for Israel. And then he seen how niggas really are, man. He seen their true spirit, so what did he do?
Virus, it's the deep gay virus, or it's hundreds of cases.
coming out that comes out today called the Hot Zone. And in the Hot Zone, it's basically about how it goes into basically the Ebola outbreak that's going on, but how it's actually affected and spread throughout the United States. Okay? How it came from the infection of a monkey, you know? And they contracted it, and it started to become widespread. They don't put these in these shows, you know, for you know.
He's like, all showing you people on purpose, man.
He's just putting it right in your face, man.
I can't think of the phrase.
Predict the program.
Hey, cause he not only puts it in shows or movies, he puts it in video games, he throws it in trailers, trailers and everything. Music, it's everywhere, man. He saw us throwing it right in y'all people's faces, y'all just like entertainment, like it's not
going to
be happening
to you. That's a lot of you. We got certain whistleblowers on YouTube that's already saying that there's hundreds of cases of Ebola already in the States. It's just not being reported by mainstream media.
And it's undetectable.
And it's undetectable. One guy didn't even know he had it until he recognized that he was sick. But he didn't know what it was, but then one of his eyeballs, it turned from blue to green. So basically, he had it, and it was forming in his eyeball. Okay? So you don't even know, man, and your immune system is already broken because of the traditional medicine diet. So, the powers that be, they're making sure that you people are not immune from this coming back. Because why the pestilence is going right now, a lot of you people are
Lord, your help. I will bring plagues upon the world.
he's setting up certain moves so that they all hit you at once, man. So that you get checkmated, basically, man. So by him allowing Esau to pollute the air, pollute the earth, pollute the water, you know, which is breaking down your immune system because you're eating garbage. You know, then that's allowing the famine to hit you quicker. Then that's allowing the diseases to hit you harder. You know, then that's not allowing you to fight against the martial law, against the race riots, and which is gonna make it easier for him to round you up, which is gonna make it easier for him to chip you. Cause then you're gonna be willing once Esau presents, oh yeah, this medicine here, if you get this chip, we're gonna give you this medicine and it's gonna cure you. It's a number of things that Esau is gonna set up. Hey, because the Most High told him to do it this way, man. In America, and you people find nothing wrong with it. Hey, that's why the Most High is gonna bring these plagues and these scourges for you people. Hey, we can go into some more of them plagues when we grab a list myself in the 17th chapter.
Verse 10, it said, "Behold, my people is led as a flock to the slaughter. I will now suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt. But I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm and smite Egypt with plagues as before."
Connor, and that's not talking about Egypt over in Africa. That's talking about this Egypt. And because in Revelation, the book of Revelation, it tells you that this is spiritually Sodom and Egypt, man. Going back into those... into the homosexuality that America is declaring their sin of Sodom, and then going back into Egypt, which held us captive. And the same thing is happening within this land. So as it says, plaguing Egypt as before, it's talking about America, being that the Most High plagued Egypt, ancient Egypt, with the 10 plagues, and then killed off the Egyptians. Hey, the same thing is happening in